She's like, women, they tell us, the women who work on fields, to shut up, that your voices don't matter, that you live in the shadows. We don't want to hear from you. And they tell you women in the spotlight, shut up. No one wants to hear from you. And she said, they're telling us all to shut up. They're giving us the same message, whether we live in the shadows or we live in the spotlight. And we have to be willing to bust out of those silos and those divides. And so when you look at the incredible women of the US soccer team who are doing a better job at their job than the men in their field. I mean, that's just
by far.
Like, it's not even, oh, we're not getting paid the same to do the same job. No, they're doing a better job and they're getting paid less. And it's not just about getting paid less. It's about all the other resources around it that, you know, the men's soccer team flies private so they can get their rest. You know, where like the women have to fly commercial because of the argument that it's just not profitable. You're just not, you know, you just don't mean as much. And at a certain point, like when you see that the most successful, the most, you know, like the most
talented,
visible,
yeah,
and you know, highly celebrated women in our society are still expected to shut up and take what's given to them, it puts it on, you know, in a light that you just can't ignore. And the fact that these women chose to use their platform and their moment where they were succeeding and making us all proud, you know, that they chose to take that moment and speak up for what was not just for women, that was true for women in their industry and true for women across industries. It was so empowering, so inspiring. And Natalie Portman, our dear sister who we love so much, she led it. She led the charge and gathered us to talk to the US women's soccer team. And so, yes, like you said, this came out of that for her. And so for me, signing on to this was a no-brainer because it's saying, you know, A, the fact that this is majority female owned, that this team and this club will be majority female owned. A lot of the owning members are soccer players or ex-soccer players, that we will get to set a model, a new bar for how women in sports should be treated and how women everywhere should be treated.